Although they are 1,000 years apart, that technology, that knowledge still exists. Okay? This is an important thing that you have to carry. Nobody aided, nobody could aid even today. I was alone with my own people. Nobody came, no engineer came, no engineer questioned. We are doing everything independently. With all our consciousness at it, that is very important. Every stone, when it was laid over another stone, we examined. There is one secret which I told you I will reveal. How this stone lies firm on the stone below. The bottom will be concaved. And top will be perfect, this spirit level. When it is actually put on the stone below, the edges all over, that is bright the stone below. It's called biting. Biting. Just like your teeth, you are biting some mango or something like that. It will bite the stone below. So that convexity is responsible for the stability of each and every stone. If I put one stone like that and every stone like that, the whole structure will be biting with each other. In other words, without mortar, they will never move. There is no shear in this case. Even if earthquake comes, it will not move. There is another thing which I would like to reveal. I don't think that anybody has discovered that by my lineage or knowledge handed down from generation to generation prompts me to tell you the secret. Around this enclosure wall, they have got a moat. Always filled with what is called water. People should not come into the temple because the king was afraid that people will destroy. So there was water outside, and inside he put crocodiles. It's a very dangerous animal. It will bite with a multi teeth. But in between there was also a plank for people to go. And this is a simple bridge. That dampness around the temple keeps the temperature and also hardness of the temple space. Even if it is dry, the foundation just below the main shrine will be always one and the same. It has been remaining for the past 1,018 years. That is why it is stable. Added to that, now just below, even here you can see from the moat, section of the moat, there is soft rock. So it is founded on soft rock. But rock also should maintain the hardness of the rock, soil, because it is very heavy. My small structure, 133 feet, weighs 7,000 tons. Okay, you double, then 15,000 tons. So that will be the weight. So that will crash down. And your earthquake will also come because of the crushing strength. So that is how this was designed and constructed. So that great man has to be bowed by one and all. You please worship the structure. You ignore your God. God is always with you, but the structure is not with you. Correct? Yes. So that is why we say, even if you worship the structure, that is more than enough. And there is a big saying in our scripture, Prasadam Purusham Matva Pujet Mantravitamaha. One who is well versed in chanting Vedic mantras, he must go to the structure, look at the structure, and assume it as the form of God, and then do pujas. How great. So worship of this temple structure itself is great. Then if you are interested, if you are permitted, you can go into the main sanctum or main cell and look at the God. If you are not permitted, ignore him, he will follow you. Because he is always inside, he is following you whether you like it or not. So that God, how does it exist? And I have told you that you have got this central consciousness, thread of consciousness, which is called Brahma Sutra, which is called Brahma Stambha, that is Brahma pillar. So every human being has got this kind of shaft inside. Because of the existence of that kind of Brahma Sutra or shaft, you are able to sit like this, like this, like this, like this. Otherwise you will fall down. It is that balancing line. It is almost your plumb. When you construct a wall, you have got the plumb. Without plumb, you can't raise even a single wall. So that keeps it all right. So this is the human plumb. Invisible plumb that is actually in you. So that is called Brahma Sutra. Brahma is divine or light. Sutra is thread. Therefore, that Brahma Sutra has been enlarged a million times. That is called a linga. Okay, that lingam will go inside. There is no bar, I think, because all Hindu temples, according to me, must be thrown open to all people. If you say that God belongs to everybody, otherwise you are shutting your eyes. You have become very ignorant of your own culture. I am only scolding my own people, not you. Now, another point that you have to note, we entered by the main entrance and it is superposed with a structure. The structure is called Gopuram. Okay, there is a meaning for the title Gopuram. And when you come inside, that is space after space, a passage after passage, ultimately you will go to the sanctum, inner self. So this is called a Vimanam, not Gopuram. Very important. Even archaeologists commit mistakes. They are not able to distinguish between the Vimanam and Gopuram. So one archaeologist spoke like that. And added to that, these archaeologists do not know where from the story should be counted, whether we have to take into consideration the ground floor or not. We have to ignore the ground floor. When you see one story the building, we have to always drop this ground floor and then count from about terrace level. That is universal, a concept of numbering stories, similarly here. So this is 13 story the tower. In English it is called tower, but in our language, technical language, it is called Vimanam. So this is Brihadeeswara Vimanam. Please tell me. Not Gopuram. Gopuram is simply means entrance tower. Our people always commit mistakes. And how do they commit mistakes? Not only old people, only youngsters. We have the only common word. Anything rising, we call tower. Actually, what we are living here, that is a place where we are living. In the fifth floor we are sleeping. It is called a tower. A towering house or building. Yes. So tower, anything rise is tower. So far as English is concerned, that's correct. But when you come to the actual word that we are using from time immemorial, it is the entrance is Gopuram and then it is Vimanam. Why it is called Gopuram? Why it is called? What is the meaning of the word Vimanam? Vimanam means measure. Vimanam means number of measures we have made use of in the construction and design. And Gopuram is, we are called soul. In Tamil, we call Pasu, or Jeeva, or energy. Right? So all energies, even ant, elephant, yourself, myself, everybody come from outside, inside. So it is called Gavampuram. This is the place by which all these Pasus, all these souls move in. So that is the significance of that tower. So all these things have to be learned only from technical people. These technical people have been ignored by a very ignorant society. What to do? I am going to weep, weeping, weeping, weeping. That is why I am passing this kind of knowledge into the hands of other people who seek my help. Understand? How angry I am. So this is actually the place where I have to sit. I am actually sitting on this garland. That is the main garland. The tail garland. The tail zone. Now we will move about. Now this consists of, originally it consists of all these structures came late. Our kings came and they wanted to keep their name also remembered forever. Therefore they added front and other front. In that way it got expanded. But the peripheral measure, as actually designed by the original architect, still exists. So, as I said, the enclosed space becomes a living organism. So it's a living organism. This is actually the Brahma stone. Brahma Bindu is there inside. Understand? You must be knowing. Our people do not know. So this is strictly according to science. It is only from the atom this cosmos have evolved. Okay? Step by step in wavy patterns. So we are now within the first enclosure. This is the wave. This is actually called your sacred place. When you say sacred space, sacred architecture, all are fully related to this kind of space. So these are all measured spaces. So in as much as you have got spaces in this space, upper space, they are going in square, square, square. All these peripheral ones will be square, square, square. In between you have got passages. All passages, that is for circumambulation going around, that those passages are called prakaras. The word prakara simply means enlarged space. Akara is a form, prakara means enlarged, extended form. So God form is there at the center, it is extended. By whom? By its mere evolution or expansion of spaces. Just like you are throwing stone on the still water, you have number of waves. All these wave patterns in the space above are square, 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 not round, 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 as we find it on the water, but this is square. It is otherwise called, this is, my dear Michael Barton, heaven on earth. This is not heaven and the earth. This is heaven on earth. This is our Indian culture, which is actually 10,000 years old. Nobody knows your board on the wall. It gives only the period after Christ or before Christ. So before Christ, there are a number of Christ in the whole of our universe. And once upon a time, about 10,000 years ago, we had academies, Tamil academies they were called. First academy, second academy, third academy. During the first academy day, the concept was actually discovered and given form. And thereafter, it has been coming like this. Unfortunately, there was a very serious tsunami attack in the, on the first academy of Tamil, evolution or creation or development. Whatever escaped out of that tsunami attack, we are having today, summarized or a simplified version is called Simple Shastra or Vastu Shastra. Originally, it was called Sthapati Veda. I am called Sthapati because I am authorized to design and execute. Sthapana means establishment. And the definition of Sthapati is Sthapanadipatihi yasmat tasmat sthapati ucchate. He is authorized to design and execute. Even today, only engineers are permitted to raise multi-story buildings. Huts we can build. But buildings, actual buildings, because now we are threatened by so many dangerous waves. Now our engineers are very alert, our government is very alert. So every building that we are going to design can be examined against the feeling of your threat of tsunami attack. Now tsunamis will never affect our structures. Now you know, this structure of mine, this will never topple down. In other words, this is going to raise a competition between this structure and this vulvar structure. So vulvar structure and also this pyramidal structure will live for another 2,000 years or even 20,000 years. It's exaggeration, but yet not the stability and strength to withstand time also. They are called timeless monuments. So statue of vulvar is going to be timeless, and this is also going to be timeless. So until you reach your zero space, how long it will take for you to reach, I don't know. It will survive. So that is actually the spiritual measure. that we have handled in the composition and also construction of this edifice. It's a great, that's why it is called a great temple. This temple is called Great Temple. There is another great temple. This is for Lord Shiva. Shiva is energy, you know. And Shiva dances. And there is a reflection of dance of Shiva also. That is the fire going through this hand and also kettle drum going here. Actually, when you look at the mirror, you will find your left eye will be right eye. So right eye will be left eye. It is called mirror reflection. So the mirror reflection of Lord Shiva is actually Vishnu. And mirror reflection of that heaven is actually very earth. Am I correct? It must be correct. Scientifically it is correct. So Bhumi or earth is Vishnu and that space is actually your Shiva. Okay. That is why we use the word bimbam. Actually the reflection. When you look down on a sheet of water, you see your own face. So your puttu will remain one and the same because it is at the center, it will change. But your glass here will be on the other side. And this side glass will be on the other side. In other words, it's a mirror reflection, you call it. So this is actually the roots of our culture, which we call religious. It is not religious. Fools call it is religious. So who says religion without science is lame. At the same time, science without religion is blind. So he has struck a balance between religion and science. So science has become religion. Religion is actually interpreted in scientific terms. So the time has come for people to know both sides. So without religion we can't live. Without science also we can't live. So we have to find a kind of integration between modern and old. Whatever is good available in the old tradition, whatever is now come forth from the modern tradition, they must be integrated and we have a peaceful and blissful lifestyle. That is our aim, not to speak proud of our own skill or stature. This is what we Sthapatis have been giving to the world for the past 10,000 years. From the attack of first Swami, that is in the days of first Tamil Academy. So this is Tamil culture. And it's also Sanskrit culture. There's no difference between Tamil and Sanskrit language. Fools say that two separate languages. And I have got my own theory and experiment. And universally accepted by great scholars, but little-minded scholars do not appreciate this kind of discovery. Anyhow. We don't find anything different from Sanskrit. So they are one and the same. Take for instance, the script for two languages are one and the same. Sanskrit should have separate, if it is a separate language, it must have a separate script. And Tamil has got its own script. But for two languages, only one script, common script. That is called Tamil Sanskrit. They are one and the same. Little people, unlettered people speak a lot of things. Stories they say. There is no story in science. Science is exact existence. Understand? So all these things we have been knowing, we have been harboring in our heart for several centuries. And our speakers, professors, always propagate wrong information. Please forget whatever you have learned before. Unlearn everything. Take this home and be happy and be well. Thank you very much for your patient hearing. Let us go around.
தலைவரி தலைவரி வந்து வன்னி மரம்
Leaving.
Yes, all the years. Number of people. So human life is like that. So you raise the foundation, your son will come, raise the wall, then your grandson will build the roof, and yes, next generation right. Will go into the house and live there.
I never photo
on.
அணியோட மகன் எடுத்து போறதுல அர்த்தம் நிறைய இருக்கு. அணி 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 பி அணி அணி பி.
So it is energy that has turned into matter. Okay?
Yes. Where is the scale carved on the stone?
Of course, it is not. These people have removed it.
Oh.
There was a big hibbit.
Mm-hmm.
2 feet 9 inches, 2 feet 9 inches into 3, how many? 11 feet. So the long stone was actually buried on the platform. These ignorant people have removed it. Now, on the wall also, you can find somewhere it will be marked. Tambi,
could
you show? Mark it. So on the wall we find
middle of the column or outside, inside.
Your language is authentically represented. How? Did he see any human being with this physical frame or body or torso? No. Everything actually he internalized and was actually an essence that settled here, and the essence came out in this kind of form. That is why it is called creative art. Correct?
They are
all vibration measures.
Thank you.
with some kind of noodles, that is yarn, string, all these things are nerves. And over the mouth of the kumbham, we put coconut, that is head. It has got three eyes, three points on it. And over that, we put over the Darbar, you know, grass. That way. So all put together, it would look like a human form. So in the form of Stamba, in the form of Stamba, the form of Stamba, Jimba, material form, he was Stamba. So God worship everywhere. Even this stuff he worship. Because God is found everywhere.
And where is?
Do you understand?
Yeah, yeah.
This is the center line.
Meaning. Alright? Now, how to realize, how to understand the bigness of the inner being, the civilian inside. So that's the kind of concept we have to give, the artist has to give. Therefore, he has kept the sentinel, the gatekeeper of human size. So if you look at this great man, or inside man will be greater. So that kind of awe and wonder will create. Apart from that, my dear sir, is my poetry also. Now this big sentinel or god, watchman or gatekeeper, has got a dendritic stick underneath his elbow. So it comes down like this. Around it you have got serpent. And in the mouth of the serpent you have got elephant. What is the size of the elephant? It is very, very big, isn't that? And if it is able to go into the mouth, it is big, or bigger than this. And if it is actually wound around this stick is bigger. And actually it is held only at this point. And what will be the size of this elbow or forehead? Such a man is actually a gatekeeper of the determined inside. He is very, very great. So that kind of immensity of the form inside is signified by this gatekeeper's form. This is why. Alright? Otherwise, how will you understand this a bit? So it will be.
He's moving counterclockwise.
Yes.
Is that to
anti-clockwise? I'm only returning only quarter direction. It's not anti-clockwise.
Oh.
It's not turning. That's only showing. It's a guess, sir. That's it.
Oh, okay.
Every object you have dances because everything is on.
Yeah.
That's why he says dance in the Shiva, plant, everything. So this is a kind of poetry rendered in a stone.
Yeah.
Sorry. So these are all the artist's work. Beast will not do all these things. We will perform puja all this. That is duty. So to maintain the greatness and telling the people the greatness of it, that is duty. Creator is something different. He always can see like lying hidden. God is also hidden. We are also human gods are also hidden. That is the beauty of Indian history.
Symbolic
see,
shows that
when I say he's a great man from USA, how can I tell him greatness? This time you come with your pant, coat, tie, and those. Oh, he's a great man. And you are actually led by some group of people, and your greatness also will increase. This is how your greatness actually exposes outside. So that is what the art is. So it's artistic form. You see how he's bending. Look at the house. So many units are there. And many ones were not. Fighting here.
What's the meaning?
I have written all this in my book.
What's the meaning of it? These 16? 16?
4, 8, 16, 32, and 16. Everything is spinning, my dear sir. This is called energy.
This is the point, you know, it's called energy point.
So they just create a rhythm, 8 on the 16, 4, 4, 8, 16.